If you can't find an email that you should have received, or you want to know what happened with an email that you sent, then stay around, because in this video I will show you how to trace email messages within the Google Admin panel. My name is Carlos and I help small businesses all over the world with a Microsoft 365 and Google Workspace subscription. For more information at itwithcarlos.com. Now, whether you are troubleshooting a missing email or trying to figure out why a message was delayed, message tracing is a tool that you want to have in your toolkit. Let me show you how it works. First off, why would you need to trace emails? Well, if any user in your organization reports missing, delayed, or failed email deliveries, tracing those messages helps you understand where they went. You can see if the email was marked as a spam, delayed, or bounced, and take action from there. It is all about communication flowing smoothly for your team. Alright, let's get started. To trace an email, you will need to log into your admin panel. You can find the admin icon within your apps in the upper right corner, where you find the 9 little dots. If you scroll down, you should be able to find it. Admin. Of course, you need to have assigned the admin role. You can also type in your browser admin.google.com and it will take you to the admin panel as well. Within the admin panel, we have to look at the menu on the left. If you don't see all the options, you can click on Show More. Then, look and click on Reporting. By scrolling down a little bit, you will find Email Log Search. We click on it. Here is where you can search for emails that any user have sent or received within your Google Workspace subscription. You will see two types of search: predefined search or custom search. Within the predefined search, you have different options that you can select. By clicking here, for example, you will have all messages from today, all messages since yesterday, in the last 7 days, or messages sent or received by your domain. Let's click on all messages since yesterday. And then we click on search. By scrolling down, we will see the result. This is showing all the messages that are sent and received within my Google Workspace subscription. Once you identify the message that you're looking for, you can click on it and it will show you detailed information about this message. We will be able to see the subject, the sender, the recipient, the date of the message ID, the message size. It will tell you if you have any attachment on this message. You will see the direction, I mean, if it is sent, received, or it could be a combination, sent and received. In that case, you will see mixed. And then you will see the status. In this case, the message has been delivered. This is indicating that there is not any problem with this message. This specific message was sent from my email address carlos@askitbe.xyz. And it was sent and received by carlos@itbe.cloud. We can see here the date and time. How long did it take to be sent and delivered? And by clicking here, we can see more details. We can read the different steps that this message went through. It was sent from Gmail and it was delivered with no error. Here's also the information about the server that received the email. We can read here the server IP address. Let's go back to see another example. Let's have a look to a message that I know had a problem. For example, this one. It was sent from my email address at Google Workspace, and it was sent to a recipient, carlos@itbe.cloud. By looking at the email address, I know this has a problem. This is misspelled. If we look at the button, we can see here bounced. It means that this message bounced back. And it took almost 1 second to bounce back. If we click here, we can see the details. on the steps that this message went through. And we can read here, for example, domain name not found. This domain name doesn't exist. And this is the reason why this message bounced back. Let's go back to the search results. In my case, the result, when I'm looking old messages since yesterday, will have just a few messages, and it will be easy to identify what I'm looking for. This is because this Google Workspace subscription or account have only one user. But if you have multiple users, the search could give you hundreds of emails, and the search could be more complicated. This is why the custom search could be more convenient in many cases. We have it here, custom search. Let's click on it. Within the custom search, there are some fields that are required. For example, the message day range. You can search for today, yesterday, 7 days, the last 7 days, or you can specify a range. You can select from to two, then you can enter the information about the sender and or the recipient as well, the sender IP address and the recipient IP address. You can also specify the subject of the message and the message ID if you have it. All these options will allow you to search or find for that specific message that you're looking for. Let's say, for example, that I'm looking for a message that I know that was sent during the last 2 days. I mean, since yesterday. I know the message was sent to this email address, carlos@itbe.cloud. And if I had more information about this message, I could add it here. I could also add the information of the sender, I mean the specific email address, and click on search again. In this case, I have narrowed down my search. I found only 2 messages, both sent on October 14. If I click on the message, I will get more detailed information. I can see here the subject, the sender, the recipient, which is carlos@itbe.cloud, the date and time, the message ID, the size, no attachment, and it was sent. And the status is delivered, so there was no problem with this message. It took less than a second to be delivered. I'm going to do a new search. It is going to be a custom search, and I clicked just since yesterday. This is basically the same predefined search that we did before. I'm going to click on search, and I can see here all the results. By the way, this is showing me only 10 results, but I have a second page. I click to go to the second page, and there is just one more message. I'm going to click on this one. Again, I can see the subject, the sender, and I can see there are 3 recipients. It means that this message was sent to 3 different email addresses. Under direction, I can see here it's mixed. This means that this message was received and also delivered. This specific message was forwarded to this email address, csalas2283@outlook.com. I have an automatic forwarder configured for this email address. By the way, if you want to learn about automatic forwarders in Google Workspace, here I leave you a link to the video that explains how to do this. As you can see, messages that were delivered and received, that includes the bounce back messages, like for example this one, deliver status notification. This is a typical bounce back. If we click on it, we will see the details of the bounce back. When you look at the details of a specific message, and you can read here, delivered, that indicates that the message was received by the recipient server. If for any reason the recipients can't find this message, the investigation will have to be done by the recipient end. In some cases, their administrator will have to take care of it. There is not further investigation that we can do from our end. In general, if we have any issues or problems sending emails to any recipient, a bounce back will be received in most cases. Depending on what you find, you can take different actions. For example, if you notice emails are going to spam, you might want to add the sender to your whitelist. If it is a delivery issue, you can check if the recipient inbox is full, or review any related email routing rules in the admin panel. And that's a quick review on tracing emails in the Google Workspace. It is an invaluable tool for keeping your email system running smoothly. If you found this helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe for more tech tips. Have any specific question or running into issues? Drop them in the comments below, and I will do my best to help you out. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Remember, stay secure, stay tech savvy.